Today we are going to discuss two different questions. Question number 1, for 50 mm of a line, compare size of the drawing length on basis of full scale, reducing scale and enlarged scale. Question number 2, define the following curves, involute, ellipse and cycloid. So very important question for the subject engineering, drawing and design. And each question having the weightage 3 marks in the GTU examination. So GTU means Gujarat Technological University. Subject code is 3110013. Short subject name is EGD. For the diploma student is ED. So welcome to my YouTube channel, Mechanical Engineering Management. Like, share and subscribe. So in this video, we are going to discuss first question number 1 and followed by question number 2. Listen carefully the whole video, then definitely you will get 3 marks for each question in the GTU examination without any problem. So first question number 1, for 50 mm of a line, compare size of the drawing length on the basis of full scale, reducing scale and enlarged scale. So 50 mm, that is actually the actual length, or we can say true length of the line. So full scale means whatever it may be, the dimension of the actual object and the dimension in the drawing are same. So in another word, you can say the scale 1:1. So you have to draw the line AB having length 50 mm, so that the actual length is also 50 and my length in the drawing, that is also 50. So if I want to measure length of the line AB, then it is 50. So this is the 50 mm. Now reducing scale. So reducing scale, that means your drawing size is little bit reduced compared to the original length or the true length of the line. And for that you can say scale 1:2 means the drawing size, that is half of the original size. So you can say in another word that if you are far away from the original object, then your object size will be little bit reduced. So that is only for the explanation. Don't draw the figure in the examination. So your length is reduced from 50 to 25 because of I have selected the scale as 1:2. So if I want to measure the length of this line AB, then it is 25. But keep in mind that your original length of the line AB is remains constant as 50 over here also. But only you are far away from the original object, so it seems to be a small. Now third scale and large scale. And I have written the scale as 2:1. That means I have increased the size of the object as double. Means you are looking the original object with magnifying glass. So this scale is basically used for the very small element. So here I have written it is 2:1. That means original size of the object is double by magnifying glass. So what is your original size? 50. Now with the enlarged scale, your length of the AB line is now 100 mm. So I think you can understand easily the full scale, reducing scale and enlarged scale. Now the second question, the definition of involute. So it is defined as the curve traced out by the end of the thread as it is unwound or wound around a line, around a polygon or around a circle. The condition is what? The thread being kept tight. So you can understand with the help of this image. Here I have shown this red color, that is actually involute. And that involute, that is for the circle. So here I have written, it can be on the line, it can be on the polygon or it can be on the circle. And this black color, that is actually the thread, must be tight. So keep the thread must be tight. Now the second definition, that is for ellipse. So it is a locus of a point moving in a plane such that the sum of its distances from two fixed points, that is sometimes known as the foci points, always remains constant. Means if you look at this ellipse, these are the fixed points F1 and F2, foci points. And if you are looking for the P1 point, so your P1 is moving from P1 to P2 to P3, then it is like that. So if you look at the P1, then what is written in this definition? It is the locus of a point moving in a plane such that the sum of its distances from these two fixed points, F1 and F2, means P1 F1 plus P1 F2 must be equal to P2 F1 plus P2 F2 must be equal to P3 F1 plus P3 F2 must be equal to P4 F1 plus P4 F2, like that. So I can write here for the explanation only that the summation of this distance from the foci point, that means from the fixed point, that is always constant. Now next, that is the definition for cycloid. It is a path or the locus followed by a point on a circle when it moves along a straight line without slipping. So you can understand from this figure, this is the straight line. So that is written over here, along a straight line. And it is a path or locus followed by a point. So here you can see this is the black is the point on a circle. So this black point, that is on the circle. So I think you can understand the definition of involute, ellipse and cycloid. So thanks my dear friends.